So I have notes that written down so I can make sure that I get all my points across. This topic is love versus being in love. A lot of times, loving someone and being in love with something is like there's a blur gray area of the whole thing, and sometimes you don't know which thing certain things are going. Do you love the individual or does it fall under in love with that individual? There was someone, I believe it was Johnny Depp, who said it, that if you're in love with two people, go with the second one that you're in love with, because you weren't really in love with the first person to begin with. I don't agree with that. I believe that people could be in love with two people, and you still love different people. And when I say that you be in love with someone, I mean like wanting to marry in love with person, okay? And there's a lot of people out there who are in love with another individual, to whom they end up coming to find out that person isn't who they thought they were. For instance, like the worst case scenario, you're in love with someone, and you come to find out that for the last 10 years that you have known them, from when you first met them to now, you come to find out that they've been murdering people. They're like Dexter, okay? In the sense that, even if it's not like, oh, I only murder murderers type of thing, but like they murder people, they kill people nonetheless. But like, you never knew that about them, but you come find out that they've been doing this, and you never knew, you never saw the signs, and you're like a detective, and you watch out for these signs type of thing. And you come and find that out, like, finding information out like that, if that's strong, or even on the other opposite scale, not that bad, then your world can crumble drastically. I believe that you still be in love with that person, but like, you don't want to be with that person anymore. And now, some of you guys might be like, oh, never. If you find something drastic, like they murder people, and you don't want to be with them anymore, you can no longer be in love with them. And some of you guys might be thinking, oh, you just were in love with the concept that you had of them, and that's it. Because that's all it was a persona or a concept that they put out there. Like, my whole thing is, like, I feel like you still be in love with them, but, like, and I also believe that you could fall out of love, honestly. And that's why, like, there's a lot of people after, like, 25 to, like, 40 plus years end up getting a divorce because they fall out of love. I've heard people saying, like, if you end up getting a divorce, you fall out of love, you were never in love to begin with. Or you were, like I said before, in love with the concept of things. Like, your love type of thing. Cheesy Disney movies. You want to be in love with someone. You love the concept of love. And, yeah, there's people out there that's definitely teenager-y, philly type of thing. Like, I believe a lot of people would be in love with multiple people, but it's how you go about doing it. Like, do you want the two people that you're in love with, do you want to marry them type of in love, or not? And like, this is where the whole thing of definitely the line of, like, is it measure material in love, or do you just love them like a family member or a friend? You love them. Like, there's a lot of people, like, I love my parents, but I'm not in love with them. I love my husband, and I'm in love with him too. I love how the acting of particular actors are and everything like that. And all that. I remember a friend of mine, right, that had sophomore year of high school, who brought up the whole topic of love. And she ended up saying that the first person you love is your mother, because you're basically being developed in her to be in, to the point of being born and all that. You love your mom. Then you love your dad or your other parent and all that. Like, two moms, you love both of them. Your two dads, your uncle, aunt, your uncle, mom, your aunt, dad, grandparents. You love your family. Some people I've heard say that you could be in love with them. And, like, depending on how things are, that's called incest. Okay. In a lot of cultures, like, a big no-no. Okay. But yeah, and that's, I remember after being told that and getting in the line of, like, if you love, or in love with two people, go for the second person. And I brought up to people many years ago saying that I'm in love, type of love, like, family relationships with a bunch of people, my parents, my sister, so a few other relatives and everything, but, like, it's the whole thing of, like, do I have to choose who I love? And how do I choose? Like, I love both of my parents. Like, going on the whole thing of, like, I love my mom, I love my dad. Now that my dad's the second person I love, do I just say I just love him and not love my mom? I love my sister now. Because I love my sister, can I no longer love my parents? And it goes, I had the whole thought of that whole thing. It's like, then now I love my husband. Now I love my husband now. Can I no longer love my sister or my parents also? That whole thing is like, it's the whole thing of, like, where does the line cross? It's like, is there a line saying this is what love is and this is what in love is? And I don't know how many of you guys think about that. And but for this, it's kind of in the back of my mind of, like, it pops up once in a while. I hear things and or see that line from the actor, like, oh, I'm like, it's a part of me when I see that line, like, you can't be in love with two people and everything. And it just rubs me wrong, because, like, love is, like, another way of deeply caring for someone. And how can you not care about people? Like, yeah, even I have this problem of, like, really disliking others. I mean, like, seriously. Like, there's one person I know to where, since we were both in fifth grade at least, and I didn't care for her. I started really disliking her my senior year of high school, which was, like, 2006, 2007. Towards the end of my school year in 2007 of high school. And I still have that, I don't want to say hatred, but I feel like it's almost like that, but extreme dislike of this woman. And I haven't really talked to this individual in years and really interacted with. My feelings for her should be gone. But I have this dislike, and whenever I think of her, just seeing her face in my mind, I go, oh, God, her, you know. But yeah, there's that whole thing. I'm not. But, like, my husband, like, he, with one of his ex-girlfriends that we've both known since elementary. We all known each other the same amount of time, first grade. I know he loves her. He deeply cares for her. And I understand that, and I know things that all three of us know things of each other, and I know what he taught, some of the things that he's brought up before, and I do believe he loves her, But it's not going to be one of those things to where he'll leave me for her at all. It's not that situation at all. And I know there's a lot of people out there who, even like in my situation, to where I'm the person after this other chick, and they marries and everything, has a family, children, all this and all that, and still ends up going back to the other person. And there, a lot of people, I don't know, psychologists would say that, but like, if my husband did that, had kids with me, married me, and all this other stuff, and still went back to his ex-girlfriend that he loves, he, or some psychologists and people would say he was never in love with me. He was just strictly in love with her. And that's it. And I don't believe that's how my husband is. But that's, I'm not going to get more detail on that. But like, that's just an example. But yeah, let me know in the comments below your thoughts of it. And the whole concept of loving someone and then being in love. Like, what classifies what type of thing. Until next time, peace. And if you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Don't forget to like this video and share it.